kind of is the natural outcome. You don't have to worry about the having when you start with the be question. I want to be, you know, loving towards my neighbor. I want to be provide a container of safety for people to do their spiritual and reflection work as activists. So really, I think a lot of it is around getting out of the things that place doing above who, how we are with one another. That's one thing. The other piece I think about growing our souls is the idea of Sangha or community. Like, it's easier to be on a path when we're together than it is to do it alone. It's the pathological individualism that makes us think we have to do it all alone. And we need 100 hammers for 100 people when we're isolated. We don't need 100 hammers when we're together. And we're passing the same 10 hammers around the community. There's more than enough when we're connected to one another. It's when we're separated that. And being in community forces you to grow your soul as a stretch because you have to be in relationship with other people. The other piece I think that ancestors have been really calling me to for the last 5 years is around bringing back traditional medicine and traditional healing ways of releasing the energy that we... So as we're doing the activist work, we're around some intense energy. There's a lot of fear energy around. Change is happening, whether people like it or not. The demographics of this country are changing, whether people like it or not. And there's a lot of fear associated. What does that mean?